أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب وجعلناه هدى لبني إسرائيل ألا تتخذوا من دوني وكيلا. ذرية من حملنا مع نوح إنه كان عبدا شكورا. وقضينا إلى بني إسرائيل في الكتاب لتفسدن في الأرض مرتين ولتعلن علوا كبيرا. فإذا جاء وعد أولاهما بعثنا عليكم عبادا لنا أولي بأس شديد فجاسوا خلال الديار وكان وعدا مفعولا. ثم رددنا لكم الكرة عليهم وأمددناكم بأموال وبنين وجعلناكم أكثر نفيرا. إن أحسنتم لأنفسكم وإن أسأتم فلها. فإذا جاء وعد الآخرة ليسوءوا وجوهكم وليدخلوا المسجد كما دخلوه أول مرة وليتبروا ما علوا تتبيرا. عسى ربكم أن يرحمكم وإن عدتم عدنا وجعلنا جهنم للكافرين حصيرا. إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا. وأن الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة أعتدنا لهم عذابا أليما. ويدعو الإنسان بالشر دعاءه بالخير وكان الإنسان عجولا. وجعلنا الليل والنهار
Okay. Your time is now up. Inshallah, we'll go over to the judges for your questions, inshallah. So we'll begin with Sheikh Abdullah.
Inshallah. You recited the first ayah. Subhan alladhi asra. What is the mad rule taking place here?
It is mad munfasil, disconnected mad. Because after the ya, which is a stretched letter, there is a hamza in the next word.
Okay, and how long do you stretch this for?
You stretch it for 4 to 5 counts.
Okay, inshallah. So, okay. Sheikh Nasrullah.
هدى لبني إسرائيل. هدى لبني. Is there any?
Yes, there is. There is إدغام without ghunnah, because after the tanween on the dal, there's a shadda on the lam, which means you connect it, but without ghunnah.
Okay. Excellent. Sheikh Abdul Mannan, two questions, please.
Okay, Omar. Abadan Shakura, what's happening? Abadan Shakura, between these two words?
Between the Abad and Shakura, there is Ikhfa, because on the Dal there is Tanween, and then since Sheen is an Ikhfa letter, it will create a nasal sound and it will be Ikhfa.
How would you say the word?
Abadan Shakura.
Okay, that's the first question. Second one, Fil Arudi Dod. What is the makhraj of Dod?
His full mouth, because Dod is a full mouth letter.
Makhraj.
Oh, Dod. When the tip of your tongue touches the back of the teeth.
Do you know what letter I'm asking you?
Dod.
Dod, yeah?
Yeah.
So, Dod. So, say again, the makhraj Dod.
When Dod is touching the top of the...
Which part of the tongue?
The front of the... The tip of the tongue, like the front of the tongue, is touching the roof of the mouth.
So that's a dal, isn't it? Ad.
Sorry?
That becomes dal. Ad. So what's dal? Dal makhraj?
Dal is the same, but like, it's pronounced differently.
So you're going to say dal and dot, same makhraj?
No, it's...
I'm not sure. Okay.
Jazakumullah khairan, Umar. Well done with your beautiful recitation, mashallah. What have you chosen for us in terms of your topic?
Since we can learn from Isra wal Mi'raj.
Okay, mashallah. Beautiful topic. So, Umar, you have 3 to 4 minutes and you can start when you're ready, please, inshallah.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina. ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى. Glory be to the one who sent his servant on a night journey from the Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. Mentioned in these verses are the miraculous events of Isra wal-Mi'raj. On this special night, our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam traveled with Angel Jibreel to Masjid al-Aqsa in one night. He traveled to Masjid al-Aqsa in one night, and thereafter he led all the prophets in Salah and transcended to the heavens. Many ulama mentioned that this was in Aam al-Huzn, which is the year of sorrow. And in this year, two of the closest companions to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Firstly, Abu Talib, his beloved uncle. Abu Talib is the man who took the Prophet ﷺ in when he was an orphan and treated him like his own son. And he protected him from the Quraysh in Mecca when he was under persecution. And Khadija, his beloved wife, who was the first one to believe in him and the only one to believe in him when nobody else did. And it was at this point in time, after that they had died, he transcended into the heavens and was in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lesson we can learn from this is that inna ma'al usri yusra, with hardship comes ease. But so if we are going through hardship, maybe a loved one passing away or family member or something, poverty stricken, ease will always come. And it's mentioned in the hadith, it's mentioned in Surah Ahzab, that لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا.
the best of role model, in the Messenger of Allah is the best role model. In the Messenger of Allah is a blessed role model. And this is significant because it really shows the importance and the fact that we should strive to be like the Prophet. And we should always remember to be patient even when we're going through struggles. And we should always remember Allah and remember that He is Al-Alim, the All-Knowing, and He knows what He has planned for us. So I would like to end off by saying that if you're in any hardship, just never forget, إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
As-salamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Umar, very well delivered, mashallah, tabarakallah. Very good topic they've chosen as well, mashallah. Shabd al-Mannan, very briefly, inshallah.
Yeah, mashallah, for your age, you're 13 years old, right, Umar?
14.
Now you're 14. Okay, still young, mashallah, in that age. Alhamdulillah, bringing our topic, إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. It's not easy. Well, many of us go through difficulty in our life. Alhamdulillah, brought the topic, which is good. People, in fact, go through depressed. They can't take anymore. So this is a remedy, mashallah. Can you speak on that? Alhamdulillah, it's good. People will be learning for it. Inshallah, we'll be learning. Mashallah. Well done. Keep it up, mashallah.
Well done, Umar. May Allah bless you and reward you. Inshallah, you can take your seat. Jazakumullahu khairan. So, mashallah, that was Muhammad Umar Hussein from London with his beautiful recitation and his well-delivered speech.